It's the CTV Beam Game of the Week. The Chattahoochee Valley Pirates versus the Faulkner State Sun Chiefs. Hello, everybody. This is Victor Feliciano, alongside Anton English behind the camera, and a new member of our announcing crew, Chad Dixon. We're going to bring you the play-by-play action of college basketball, the first one of this season. CVCC comes in with a record of 10-3. This is their conference opener against Faulkner State. Actually, it's a conference opener for both teams. And CVCC is coming in with quite some challenge as they've lost some of their key players. And Chad, tell us a little bit more about that. We've got a chance, and we'll be able to talk to Coach in a few moments.
Well, you have two of their CVCC's major guns out in this game. Anthony Moore is second in the Alabama Community College Conference with 231 points and fifth in rebounds with 8 per game. And then you have Tim Knight. Tim White, he is actually second, averaging 9.4 rebounds a game, second in the conference. So they're going to have to rely on some of their younger players in this area or division opener. The interesting thing about both these teams right now is they haven't played in the better part of a month. So there could be some rust on each side. But like I said, the underclassmen and some of the sophomores that haven't played as many minutes are going to have to make up for the difference with Moore and White being out this game. One name that comes to mind is Pernell Biggerstaff, who hit double digits in their last game against LaGrange on December 11th, where they won 78-49.
And we got a chance to talk to Coach Richard Mahone of the CVCC Pirates. And I'm here with Coach Richard Mahone of the CVCC Pirates. Coach Mahone, thank you for letting us come out and showcase the Pirates. And for those who are not familiar, they know that you guys are here, but tell us a little bit about yourself and your background as far as coaching. And
well, I'll tell you what, I'm really glad, Victor, you came over tonight and everything, and to give our basketball program coverage tonight. Local boy, I'm a graduate of Carver High School. I graduated in 69 and then left there and went to Fort Valley State University. And I've been in coaching now with the 30 years I had in the state of Georgia with working at high schools in Columbus State. I came over here in 2004 and 2005 and then I've been here now a total of 13 years. And really proud of the program that we do have here. I tell you what, our kids have really worked it hard, and we've had some real good student athletes to play here and go to the next level. It was not a big change in the 35-second clock when I left the high school because I played up-tempo and quick hitters. When I got here, it didn't even bother me at all because that's the same style of basketball that we play. Occasionally, sometimes, we have to take a shot because of the clock, because sometimes opponent's defense is kind of turning up on us and stuff like that. But we play up tempo. We do quick hitters. We do pattern offenses and we open the flow sometime and then we post big guys up. So that's our style of play. And fortunately, we've started off with a great year. We are we're 10-3 and had a real decent postseason play before the start of the season. And tonight we start conference play. So we're really excited about tonight. Mm-hmm.
Tell us about a player or two that we'll probably be calling out their names a good bit tonight.
Well, we have a variety of good players. I would like to say that we have Parnell Bickerstaff. He's from Opelika, Alabama. This is his second year. We have a transfer from Augusta, Georgia, named Frank Roberts. Good player, he's in our post. He does a great job. We also have a kid named Tim. Tim is from Albany, and he's a 6'6 kid. He plays real well around the basket for us. So we got a variety of balanced kids, no superstar. So we just try to get the ball to everybody and let them have fun.
One of the things that I've noticed on our schedule is this is going to be the first game that you've played in pretty much a month competitively. So tell us about what you're coaching them up to this point, knowing that there might be a little rust there.
Well, because of our we don't have the dormitories and we don't have the dining hall, When I first got here, I played in a whole lot of holiday tournaments during the Christmas holidays. And it was a tremendous burden on our fundraising to try to house the kids and feed the kids over the holidays. So what I decided to do around the Christmas time is to let them go home, spend time with their families, you know, and you know, get the nutrition that they need and everything. We do go to a tournament at Thanksgiving. So they do take off during the Thanksgiving holiday. So what we do, we go to one holiday tournament at Thanksgiving and we kind of let them off. Now we've been practicing and I'm kind of concerned about tonight because it has been a long layoff. So, but they came back and some of the guys were in pretty good shape. And we'll kind of get a feel tonight, you know, what we need to do in terms of conditioning more throughout the season. Mm-hmm. But fortunate enough, we've been in the Final Four and Elite Eight for the last 8, 9, 10 years. So, you know, but Faulkner, great team. You're going to see some good basketball from them.
What kind of style are they bringing to the table from your
Well, they have a new coach, Jack Robinson, retired after working down there for like 40-some years. And his son is taking over the program. And this is going to be a new style for me against him because I was familiar with Jack. So, I don't know if this guy is going to push the ball or not. I don't know what he's going to do. I know they're real big. So it's going to be exciting.
I want to go ahead and give you the starting lineup for the Chattahoochee Valley Pirates. At guard, number 2, Marcus Foster. Also at guard, number 10, Stefan Harris. The other guard is Parnell Vickerstaff, number 22. Number 21, Troy Campfield is the forward. Also playing forward, number 30, Franklin Roberts. And that's the starting lineup for the Chattahoochee Valley Pirates. And now for the Faulkner State Sun Chiefs, number 2, Jordan Booker. Number 3, Jacob Champion. Both of them are guards. Also at guard, number 25, Josh Lindsey Hunter. At forward, number 15, Keon Brown. And forward, number 40, Dion Dozier. All right, so we're getting ready for the tip-off here at CVCC. As we were rattling off the starting lineups for Faulkner State, I wanted to let you know that Faulkner State only has one of their regular starters starting for them. Six of their players have been suspended. They were participating in a Christmas tournament at Meridian, Mississippi, and they got into a fracas with one of the teams there, and the fighting led to suspensions. So just as CVCC is shorthanded with some of their players, as they're suiting up 8 players, the Sun Chiefs are also challenged in their roster going deep into their bench. So this is 2 teams going to try to scrap out a division win here.
This isn't really how you draw up a conference opener, with pretty much CV having their top 2 scorers down, and you're looking at Faulkner basically looking at a bunch of bench players starting for them in this conference opener. Faulkner State was 6-4 the first half of the season, stretched from November to December. CV was 10-3.
And so, 3-point attempt. It's no good. Rebound, Sun Chiefs. And now it's Jordan Booker with the rebound. And 3-point attempt. It's no good. A rebound by Vickerstaff.
Vickerstaff's going to be the player to watch here. He's got some starting time at CV this year. And in the last game, it was against LaGrange's JV squad. And he was able to post double digits in that game. And he was also able to post double digits in the previous game on December 5th.
And CVCC with several 3-point attempts falling short. Sun Chiefs doing the same thing. They're trying to strike first by the 3. And we're at 18 minutes left in the first quarter.
Quickly, if for those of you watching that haven't watched a CVCC game before, at this level, the time is actually broken into 2 halves of 20 minutes. So as we keep up with the time, bear in mind, we are broken up into halves, not quarters like high school athletics.
And the Sun Chiefs strike first after several attempts on both teams falling short and going wide. And so at 17:40 in the first half, Faulkner State 2-0. 3-point attempt. Three!
That was Bickerstaff, one of the guys to watch for the CVCC team.
Inside, number 40, Dozier, makes it 4-3, Faulkner State. CVCC quickly works it down there. As Coach mentions, they try to do a quick offense, and now with their basically starters here that are not quite familiar with the beginning gameplay, probably not as quickly as Coach Mahone wants to see it. Another three for Bickerstaff. Quickly with 6 points, and the only 6 points for the Pirates. The ball is batted away. We got a substitution coming in. Chris Quanter is coming in for Troy Campfield. And we're at 16:45 in the first half, 6-4.
A little bit more than 3 minutes into this game. Seems like a lot. Both these teams seem they're a little bit hesitant to drive in the paint.
And there's a three. A three for the Sun Chiefs.
A three by champion. So we're seeing a lot of three-point attempts being made in the last minute or so. First minute or two of the game, a lot of misses.
The drive, no good. Rebound, Sun Chiefs. Once again, 7-6, Sun Chiefs, three-point attempt, no good. The rebound.
Rebound by Booker. But there is, well, you know, you look at a game like this, and when you don't have, you know, a ton of your regular starters on the court for both teams, you kind of see a situation to where they may refuse to go to the paint a little bit. They may try the outside shot.
9-6, Sun Chiefs. 3-point attempt, no good. Three Sun Chiefs are underneath the board, and so the Pirates being outmanned with 15:28 in the first half, 9-6, Sun Chiefs. And there was a turnover there.
Foster has the ball.
And gets it off the bank. He didn't call it, but it counts. And it's 9-8, Faulkner State. The drive. A turnover.
That was Foster with the steal.
Three-point attempt, wide open, nothing but air. Once again, it's 9-8, 14:48 in the first half.
And like I said, in that situation, you know, it just seemed like too eager to go for the three-point shot. In that situation, probably would like to see him try to at least try to drive to the paint a little bit. But like I said, we're not dealing completely on both rosters with everyday players. But also the fact that these two teams haven't played in a month.
That is true. Well, now Faulkner State did play during the Christmas season, so CVCC has that month layoff.
It's been about a 2-week for them. CVCC, about a 4-week layoff.
14:25 in the first half. Once again, Faulkner State with a 9-8 lead. And a drive by Williams loses the handle. And Faulkner State dribbles out of bounds as number 30, Demetrius Caldwell, couldn't keep a handle on that and hit the side paint. And so with 14:10 in the first half, once again, CVCC just down by one, 9-8.
Bickerstaff with the inbound to Dozier, to Foster, excuse me. We'll see here if CV will make it more of a commission to try to get.
Outside 3-point attempt. Now good rebound. Roberts. He couldn't get it in. But a nice finish by Troy Campfield. And CVCC takes the lead 10-9.
That three that was missed by Bickerstaff, I believe that was only his second miss behind the three-point line in the first 6.5 minutes of this game.
We're at 13-31 in the first half. 10-9, up and down, but still kind of sloppy as far as finishing off their touches. Inbound attempt inside the number 40, Dozier. He couldn't get it. Nothing but Pirates underneath. Bickerstaff going to slow it down just a bit. He gets it over to Foster.
CVCC is actually out-rebounding Faulkner State 6-3 at this point.
And there goes Foster. Dishes it off over to Roberts. Roberts, cross-court pass. Gets it back. Bickerstaff loses. Got pit pocket by number 3, Jacob Champion. And number 30, Caldwell, scoots it in and regains the lead for Faulkner State. It's 11-10 with 12:48 in the first half. Bickerstaff looking for some help. He gets over to Roberts. Jumper, it's good. Nice jumper by Quainter. Chris Quainter with 12.5 in the first half. CVCC regains the lead, 12-11. Back and forth game right now. Once again, Pirates.
Steal by Foster.
And there's a block by Dozier. And the Pirates are trying to steal, but couldn't do it. There's an air ball. That's Quainter. Receives the pass.
That's about the fifth missed three-pointer for Faulkner State in this half.
Three-point attempt. No good. The rebounds. Dozier gets the handle on it. And it's 11:40 in the first half. Pirates leading 12-11. Caldwell.
Early on, both these teams are looking at probably shooting about 25-30% from the three-point.
Three-point attempt. It's no good. Strong rebound by Stephen Havertz. Three-point attempt. Three! A three for Franklin Roberts. Stretches the Pirates' lead to 15-11 with 11 minutes left in the first half.
That's Robert's first shot of the night, successful shot of the night.
And Williams drive. Ball knocked away.
And that might be the reason why Faulkner State's attack. They may feel like CVCC's defense is going to prevent them from scoring underneath their goal. That might be a reason why they have been so committal to the three-point shot.
And Caldwell, he's got the points in there. And timeout CVCC with 10:37 first half. CVCC leading 15-13. You're watching the CTV Beam Game of the Week.
Being pampered is every day at Newsom's Tax and Accounting. Family owned and operated since 1996. They've provided individuals and businesses with stress-free tax preparation. Plus, they offer referral fees and repeat customer discounts to all their tax clients. Dependable, accredited, and honest. Always working to get you the most from your return. Open year-round for accounting, payroll, business consulting, incorporation, and every need in between. Always pampering. Newsom's Tax and Accounting, Phoenix City.
Coming out of the timeout with 10:36 and counting, CVCC leading 15-13. We
Foster with the ball. Kicks the inside, or kicks the outside, two.
And three-point attempt. It's good! Three for Franklin Roberts. 18-13, Pirates.
That's Roberts' second three of the night.
And foul is going to go against number 10, Stephon Harris.
Four of the six shots made by the Pirates have been from behind the three-point line.
10:01 in the first half. Pirates leading 18-13. Three-point attempt. Three for Jordan Booker. Jordan Booker closes the gap for the Sun Chiefs as the Pirates lead 18-16, 9:47 and counting.
Roberts with a layup there to extend the Pirates' lead to four.
And another three for Jordan Booker. And once again, Coach Mahone calls a timeout with 9:33 in the first half. CVCC leading by one, 20-19. You're watching the CTV Beam Game of the Week.
Need some cash? Get the cash you deserve on almost everything of value with Pawn Headquarters in Phoenix City. We're waiting to help you. We loan on a wide variety of items, such as musical instruments, power tools, lawnmowers, air conditioners, sports equipment, TVs, electronics, DVDs, video games, jewelry, and much, much more. Come browse our store. You might find what you're looking for at a much lower price. Come see us today at Pawn Headquarters, 280 Bypass, Phoenix City.
Welcome back to the CTV Beam Game of the Week. CVCC, inbound pass after the timeout. Knocked away by Sun Chiefs. Jacob Champion knocking the ball. Once again, Pirates looking to inbound the pass. With 9:32 in the first half, CVCC up by one, 20-19. And Roberts looking to dribble it down and being met up by several of the Chiefs.
Coach Mahone really didn't like what he saw there toward the before the timeout. I give up.
And a steal by Caldwell, an easy layup, and they once again regained the lead, 21-20. .904 in the first half, and we've got Kevontae Williams passing it over to Foster. Back to Williams. Playing a little catch here.
But before that last timeout, Coach Mahone, apparently there was a lot of wide open looks for behind the three-point line that Faulkner State got, so I'm sure they addressed that with the team during the timeout.
And once again, Coach Mahone calls a timeout, and he's not a happy camper right now because that was a poor throw inside the paint and made it easy steal. And once again, CVCC was trying to, they made a block on the shot attempt, but the Sun Chiefs finished the two-pointer, and it's now 23-20 with 8:34 in the first half.
The Optical Shop. Enjoy the view.
Welcome back to the CTV Beam Game of the Week. CVCC. Inbound pass after the timeout. Knocked away by Sun Chiefs. Jacob Champion knocking the ball. Once again, Pirates looking to inbound the pass. With 9:32 in the first half, CVCC up by one, 20-19. And Roberts looking to dribble it down and being met up by several of the Chiefs.
Coach Mahone really didn't like what he saw there toward the before the timeout.
And a steal by Caldwell, an easy layup, and they once again regained the lead 21-20. .904 in the first half. And we've got Kevontae Williams passing it over to Faulkner. Back to Williams, playing a little catch here.
Before that last timeout, Coach Mahone, apparently there was a lot of wide open looks for behind the three-point line that Faulkner State got, so I'm sure they addressed that with the team during the timeout.
And once again, Coach Mahone calls a timeout, and he's not a happy camper right now because that was a poor throw inside the paint and made an easy steal. And once again, CVCC was trying to, they made a block on the shot attempt, but the Sun Chiefs finished the two-pointer, and it's now 23-20 with 8:34 in the first half.
Need tires? You got car trouble? We can help with all your car repairs. For the best price and service in town, call Garver's Tire and Auto. We have used tires, mounted and balanced, starting at $35. We do oil changes, computer diagnostic testing, engine and transmission repairs. We do it all at a low price. Garver's Tire and Auto, now with two locations to serve you, Phoenix City and Columbus. Garver's Tire and Auto, family owned and operated. Give our family a chance to help your family with all your auto repair.
Inbound pass by the Pirates, coming out of timeout. Coach Mahone. We're at 8:25 in the first half. The Pirates down by three, 23-20. Canfield down to Roberts, and he traveled. Turnover by the Pirates. Faulkner State's gonna look to increase their three-point lead here. We're at 8:13 in the first half.
Neither team has really tried to, or really had the opportunity to take a commanding lead in the game so far, with a 2-3-point separation.
Bickerstaff with the long rebound, and we got Harris losing the ball. Another turnover by the Pirates.
That was the Booker.
Inside, oh, nice block by Campfield. And Bickerstaff kicks it out. 3-point attempt, no good. Rebound, Campfield. This is the end out.
Pirates are seeming to have a lot of trouble trying to finish off of the paint there.
Roberts couldn't add two for the Pirates. And with 7.5 in the first half, Sun Chiefs up 23-20.
So far in the game, you have Roberts for the Pirates with 8 points, Bickerstaff with 6. Neither one has made a shot really the last 2 minutes.
And jumpers, no good. And Campfield takes the ball away, and the Pirates will look to close this 3-point deficit as we are less than 7 minutes in the half. And a rebound by Harris. And over to Campfield, puts the two in, and it's 23-22. Faulkner State, 6:44 and counting in the first half. And it was tapped up with this jump ball.
It's not really a bad foul there, either way.
Did they call foul or was it a jump ball?
Apparently it was a foul of Faulkner State.
.627 first half, 3-point attempt. Calls the bank. I think he called the bank, but either way, the Pirates take the lead 25-23. And Caldwell muscles his way in, but didn't finish the 2-pointer, but he'll go and shoot for two.
It's the 5th 3-pointer for the Pirates.
5 fouls for the Pirates, none for Faulkner State.
Actually, both teams were dotted up with 5 3-pointers apiece. in this two-point game as the Pirates lead 25-23.
As Caldwell misses his first free throw. 6:14 in the first half. Pirates leading 25-23. Makes the second one, 25-24, Pirates. 6:13 and counting. We've got Stephon Harris.
Probably looking for a big run here by one of these teams to really kind of separate themselves, because neither team has really separated themselves in the first half. Maybe a 6-0, 8-0 run by either side could make the difference in this contest.
Well, Faulkner State right now is winning the rebound competition underneath the Pirates' boards. Three-point attempt. Three for Jacob Champion. And once again, Faulkner State regains the lead, 27-25. And we'll have a foul against number 40, Leon Dozier.
That's Champion's second three on the night.
And that'll put Kevontae Williams on the line. They shoot for two, 5:31 in the first half. Faulkner State leading by two. And Williams misses both of those. In a game like this, that may prove costly, these free throws attempts that are being missed. 5:20 in first half. And Faulkner State in the charcoal jerseys.
Near steal there by Foster.
5:12 in the first half. Once again, Faulkner State up by two, 27-25. And Booker inbounds the pass over to Caldwell. And shot clock at two. Three-pointer no good. Vickerstaff with a nice rebound. Under 5 minutes, Vickerstaff going down to the line. And the ball loose. And they're going to, it'll remain Pirates ball with 4:51 in the first half. 27-25, Faulkner State.
Seems like they've really keyed in on Bickerstaff. He's found himself in a lot of double coverage so far in the first half.
Williams driving in. And once again, foul against Deion Dozier. And Kevontae Williams will once again come to the line to see if he can knock these two in. Got that one.
First free throw for the Pirates in this game. Successful free throw.
And let's see if Williams can tie this game up. We got a tie ball game. 4:48 first half.
Williams' first 2 points on the night.
27 all.
Both teams, honestly, are about even on the rebounding department. I got them down for eight apiece. CV was able to win the rebound battle in the first part of the first half, and Faulkner State's come on strong rebound-wise in the second half.
Three!
Second half of the first quarter, first half.
Lindsey Hunter with the tray. 4:23 and counting. And once again, Faulkner State up by three, 30-27. However, the Pirates with the air ball was trying to tie it up. And there's a foul called. That one would be called against Harris. As number 15 for Faulkner State is trying to work his way into the basket. Keon Brown. And so he drew the foul and stretches the lead 31-27. 4:08 in the first half. 32-27 Faulkner State. Once again, 408 first half.
It's 8 points for Brown, which leads Faulkner State at this point in time.
Double teamed on outside to Williams. In the paint, nice finish by Cavante Williams. And it's 32-29.
I'd like to see CVCC do a lot more of that, being able to finish in the paint.
340 and counting in the first half. Caldwell for three, no good. Vickerstaff with the rebound. 332 and counting in first half.
When you look up at the school board, you see that 3-point deficit. You're really eager at some point to drain a three to tie the game, but a lot of times, especially in the first half, it just honestly put more pressure on the defense underneath the goal.
And Williams kicks it out to Harris and rebound by Brown. 3:03 and counting in the first half. 3-point attempt. Three!
So another wide open shot for Faulkner State.
Caldwell with the tray, and Coach Mahone calls a timeout with 2:52 in the first half. Faulkner State leading 35-29. You're watching the CTV Beam Game of the Week.
The Optical Shop. Enjoy the view.
Coming out of the CVCC timeout with 2:50 and counting in the first half, Faulkner State leading 35-29. Once again, this is our first showing of Pirate basketball. We'll show them one more time, at least one more time throughout the year. We're also going to be showing the Lady Pirates towards the next time we get to come to CVCC. Stay tuned. We'll keep you posted of dates and times.
Big rebound there.
That was Roberts and Harris. Couldn't finish it, but nice touch. Nice touch by Quainter. And the Pirates are down 35-31 with 2:05. And there's going to be a foul against Quainter. 2:03 in the first half, 35-31. That score sounds familiar.
Yeah.
And Faulkner State leading.
Well, this game so far, this has pretty much been the extent of the biggest lead margin.
Three is no good. Vickerstaff takes it over to Williams. Inside to Quainter. The rebound and finish by Roberts. And the Pirates are down by two, 35-33.
And that gives Roberts 10 points for the game so far.
If you're just joining us, both teams have pretty much players that are on the bench due to either discipline or academic issues.
Yes, CVCC is missing Anthony Moore and his 231 points on the season, which is second the ACCC. He's also averaging 8 rebounds a game. And they are missing number three by number. I believe that's about his 6th three-pointer in this game.
And another timeout by CVCC with 55.5 seconds in the first half, 38-33, Faulkner State. You're watching the CTV Beam Game of the Week. Oh, coming out of the timeout with 55.5 and counting. CVCC called the timeout. They got one left. Faulkner State has six.
And right now, I just think you would have put some points on the board going into the half. You don't necessarily would have had to feel like you have to tie it up right here.
Three! Franklin Roberts. It's 38-36, Faulkner State as the Pirates.
Roberts now has 13 points on the game and three three-pointers.
23, 22, 21. And he traveled. Had Pirates all over him.
Pirates got a good opportunity here to tie the game up before halftime.
And Caldwell shuffled his feet. 15 seconds. And obviously Pirates are looking for that last shot right here. And we're at 8 seconds, seven, then six. Three-point attempt, no good. That would have been a pretty, but let's finish it this way. And they do, just in time. And we got a tie ball game, 38-38.
Huge rebound there by Roberts. Gives him 15 points on the half.
So after the first half, we got a tie ball game between Faulkner State and CVCC, 38-38. You're watching the CTV Beam Game of the Week.